Hi, GOH. This is Unit 2, Lesson 5, and today we're going to do translations and rotations off the coordinate plane, which are a little bit trickier. You're going to need your compass and your protractor. So in this first example here, you can see that we have line AB, and it says, as we learned, a translated object follows the path of a vector. If we were to connect each pre-image point with its image point, we would have congruent and parallel segments. So in this diagram, segment AB is translated to produce A prime B prime. And they've helped us out. They've already drawn A prime. And the next problem we do, it's not going to be drawn. We're going to have to draw the first point ourselves. So the first thing, A, they want us to draw the vector that defines this translation. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take my compass, and I'm sort of using my compass as a ruler. I am measuring the length of AB. So I put one end of my compass on A. And then you open it up until you have the other end of your compass on B. So you guys have those ruler compasses, so you're just sliding that until you see B in the opening. So I'm measuring AB. Now I'm going to go to A prime, and I'm going to draw an arc from A prime with the same exact radius. So B prime is going to be somewhere along this line. I got to figure out exactly where on that line it is. So now I'm going to measure from A to A prime. Okay. Oh, and it's the same exact thing. Okay, that was just by chance. So I'm measuring to A prime. And then I come up to B and I draw an arc with the same radius. This is exactly where B prime will be. So this right here is my B prime. Make a little point there so you know that that's what I'm connecting. So that's my B prime. And I'm going to draw a line connecting those. Okay, so part A was to draw the vector that defines this translation. Part B, locate B prime. So let me call this B prime right here. So this right here was B prime. And construct segment A prime B prime. So there we go. All done. Now I'm going to need a compass for example 2. Example 2 is a little bit harder. I again am taking that line CD, and I'm going to translate it, the length of AB and the direction of AB. So I'm translating it by vector AB. That's what this right here is telling me to do. So first step is I draw a circle at C and a circle at D with radius AB. So I'm going to measure the length of this vector. Okay, so first step is I'm going to measure the length. You have to figure out the length that you're translating each point and the direction. So here's my length, right? So then I go to C and I go to D, and I'm going to draw. Now it says draw a circle. I know that I'm moving it to the left, so I really don't need the part of the circle that's going to go to the right. All right, I'm going to come up here and do C, same thing. All right, so that's the first step. And then I am going to draw circle B with radius AC. So what does that mean? So that's the length of it. I'm going to measure from C. I'm trying to move point C. Oops, I didn't want to move that. That's for sure. Let me move that back to where it was. I wanted to move my compass. There we go. I'm going to measure C, the distance from the point I'm trying to move. I'm trying to move C. I'm going to measure the distance from C to A. Okay, so I go from the point I'm trying to move to the beginning of the vector. So I'm measuring from C to A. And then I'm going to put my compass, that's a little too big. I'm going to put my compass on the end of the vector. So I'm going to sort of swirl this around, switch this around. So I measure from C, the point I'm trying to translate, to the beginning of the vector, and then I put my compass on the end of the vector, B, and I mark it off, and this is where point C is going to be. C prime, the image. Then I do the same thing. Let me flip this around. I do the same thing. I measure from D to the beginning of the vector. So you're measuring from the point you're trying to translate to the beginning of the vector, which is A. And then you put your compass on the end of the vector with that same radius. So I'm measuring from D to the beginning of the vector. And now I'm going to move my compass to the end of the vector at B, and I'm going to mark it off. Oop, and they sort of overlap a little bit, so I got to be careful right there. And these are my 2 points right there. So I'm going to connect those 2 points. So from here, the point of intersection, to here, the point of intersection. And then I will label those points. This right here is going to be C prime, and this right here is going to be D prime. Okay, and that's my point. And the directions are right there if you are trying to do it on your own. Alright, we flip this over to the next page. Alright, exercise 3. Given AB as shown below, construct CD such that you are basically taking point A and you're rotating it 180 degrees to get C, and you're taking point B and you're rotating it 180 degrees about point E to get D. Use only a compass and a straight edge and leave construction marks. So what we're going to do is you're going to use your straight edge. So you're going to draw a line from A through E. And I'm going to draw a line from B through E also. So sort of like that little crisscross right there. All right. Then I'm going to use my compass and measure the distance from A to E. Because remember, I'm taking A and I'm rotating it 180 degrees about point E. Let me scoot this over. So I'm measuring the distance from A to E. I'm off a tiny bit. Let's adjust that. Okay, so there's the distance from A to E. And then I'm going to move my compass and measure C should be directly the same distance on the other side of point E on that line. So again, I measure the distance from A to E, and then I'm going to move my compass to E, and I'm going to mark it off. That's going to be my C prime. And I'm going to do the same thing for B. So I'm measuring the distance from B to E. Oops, I didn't want to move that. Sometimes you grab the wrong thing here. So I'm measuring the distance from B to E. Put one end of my compass on B. Second end of my compass goes on E. Let me scoot this up a little bit so I can actually move my compass. So I'm measuring the distance from B to E. And then I'm going to move over to E. And point D will be on the exact same side, the exact opposite side, the same distance away. So this right here is going to be C, and this right here is going to be D. And I'm just going to connect those 2 points of intersection. So right here and right here, where the line and the arcs are intersecting, that's going to be my line. And the thing, let me just adjust this because I missed point D a little bit. So I can adjust mine there. You're going to line yours up carefully. And look what appears to be true about these lines is that they are parallel. Okay, so we actually just constructed parallel lines. Geometric fact. A line which is rotated 180 degrees about a point not on the line will always result in a line that is parallel to the original. Let me just, oh, those are, I don't know why those 180s got done. Down there. A line which is rotated 180 degrees about a point that is on the line will simply produce the same line. So if I have a line at a point and I rotate 180 degrees about that point, like point E, and point E is not on the line, I'm going to get another parallel line. If I was to rotate 180 degrees about the point and point E happened to be on the same line as AB, then I would just get the same exact line. All right. Let's look at example 4 here. So now you're going to use your protractor to measure the angle of rotation. So we're talking about angles of rotation here. Identify the point that is the center of rotation. Measure the angle formed by connecting corresponding vertices to the center point of rotation. Check your answer using a different set of corresponding vertices. So the first one on the left is easy. I'm rotating it about point D. Okay, because they're touching at point D, so that's the point that I'm rotating it about. Now, to find that angle of rotation, You're just going to measure any of these angles that you want, okay? Meaning I can just take, let me just do it in a different color, like I can measure this line. Let's see if that straightens out to here. Okay, so I'm going to measure that in purple. Or I could have connected C to D and then D to C prime and measured that line. So whatever you want to measure is fine. I'm just going to do the measure angle A, D prime, A prime. So I'm going to take my protractor and I'm going to move it up. Let's see if I can move my protractor up. There we go. Oh, my protractor is getting really huge. Let me see if I can get this smaller. And I'm having a hard time getting that smaller right there. So I'm going to put this here and I'm going to shift this up so it's actually on, on C prime. Okay, there. And I'm going to measure that angle. Oh, actually, I said I was doing A. So I got to measure it from, this is not turning for me. I think because my protractor is so big. I was going to measure A, D, A prime. So turn your protractor so you can do that. Okay. And be super careful as you're doing this. Because remember, my angles of rotation, let me get this gigantic protractor out of the way. My angles of rotation, there we go, it got smaller. My angles of rotation always go counterclockwise, so they go this way. So when you're setting up your protractor, you are actually measuring this. So you have two choices. My angle of rotation can either be, and as long as you're close to these numbers, you're fine. Your angle of rotation can either be 280 degrees, because remember I'm going counterclockwise, or you can say negative 80 degrees. All right, so I did a rotation, so I'm going to use a capital R. You want to say what you're rotating it about. I'm rotating it about point D. It looks like D prime, right? And you can say either 280 degrees, or you can say negative 80 degrees, so your choice. Just make sure that you're not saying 80 degrees positive. All right, and then on this one over here, I'm not sure why we got all those lines. I think those lines came from the other problem. This one, I have to connect a point. So I have to connect D to E and D prime to E. So that's my angle of rotation. So when I go to measure that with my protractor, I can see what it is. So the center of rotation is point E. And then you can take your protractor up there and measure that. And let's see if I can get my protractor to work this time. So I'm going to put this right here on E. I'm going to rotate this down so it's lined up. And then I can measure. And this time I am doing counterclockwise, so that's okay. And that looks like it's about, and you might, you know what you can do? You can actually extend this line so you can see exactly where it's hitting. But it looks like maybe it's hitting at about 52 degrees. So I'm doing a rotation about point E, and I don't know if I have subscripts on this smart board. I don't see subscripts. Let me see if this is. Oh, yeah, there we go. A rotation about point E, and what do we say, 52 degrees? Okay, so as long as you got somewhere in there, then you're great. All right, and we have one more on the next page. We're now going to locate the center of rotation. So this time the center of rotation is not there. Now the way you do this is you construct two perpendicular bisectors, and the point of intersection of those two perpendicular bisectors will be the point of rotation. So basically I'm going to connect any image to its pre-image. So I'm going to connect B to B prime, and I'm going to connect A to A prime. And I'm going to do the perpendicular bisector of B and B prime. That's that nice, easy one. You just open your compass more than halfway, and you draw an arc. You come over to the other side, and you draw an arc. Now, where those two arcs meet, I'm going to line up using my straight edge, and I'm going to draw that perpendicular bisector. So that's one perpendicular bisector. And then I have to do the perpendicular bisector for A and A prime. I'm going to change the color up that I'm doing. I'll make it red just so you can see the difference here. So the two perpendicular bisectors, where they meet, that point of intersection will be the center of rotation. So I put my compass on A, I open it more than halfway, and I